staff, where do they go? Some go off to school, some go off to work, but they miss you so. So we made some videos to show you about who knows. It's the Arrowhead Variety Show. Wah!
What is up, Arrowhead? I'm Ryan McNeil, former staff member. I have a tennis racket, which is pretty cool. But most importantly, I'm here to welcome you guys to the Arrowhead Variety Show Season 2 premiere today, Thursday. So the staff has been working hard, putting together some great content, funny videos, good laughs. But before we get into that, I just want to say, hopefully everyone's been staying safe during these unusual times. Hopefully everyone's wearing masks, being smart. And hopefully everyone's doing the best with what they got. You know, everyone's in a little tough time right now. So hopefully we can bring you guys some joy in these weird times. All right, let's get the show on the road.
Hello again, everyone. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to be back. I've missed us all so very much. So I thought today, since, you know, we're on the holiday spirit and everything, would be a great day to give you a little tour of this, this tree situation back here. There's a lot happening. This is personally how my family celebrates the holidays, but I do know everybody does it differently. So feel free to share whatever you do for the holidays, whatever you do to celebrate or decorate or anything like that. Okay, so here's a full shot of the tree. Very full, lots of ornaments. And then of course it's right next to the fireplace for easy access for Santa. We got some nutcracker action happening over here. We got two of them. This one doesn't move, but this one does. Ooh, this is a fun one. So this one's a little house. And then in the back, you can see in the house, and it has a Christmas tree and a little bedroom. It's very fun. Each of my dogs actually has their own ornament because they are so important. So this one is Lola's. We got her in 2009, so there's 2009 there. This one is Omaha's. Got a great chicken right here. What else do we have? How could I forget? The Boo Boo Baby. Here he is. So, the Boo Boo Baby, this guy right here, has been on the tree every year for probably my whole life. When I was little, my sister and I would play this game where there'd be like two ornaments hidden in our tree and we'd have to find them. And if we didn't find them in time, we would end up with the Boo Boo Baby instead of a prize. So, you know, he's a very, very staple part of the Melville family, as you can see. Unfortunately, in one of the years that our Christmas tree fell over, he suffered the loss of an arm, which was extremely tragic. But no matter what, he's still up there watching over us every December. Ooh, this one's really fun because when you open it, there are paper cranes inside. Then we got some homemade action. I made this in 2002. I was two. So this Red Sox one is from 2004 when the Red Sox won the World Series and broke that curse of the Bambino. It has 25 in the back. I'm actually not really sure why it has 25 in the back, but it does. Okay, so I actually just figured it out. It's 25 because Christmas is on the 25th. I guess that makes sense. And of course, we have support for the Patriots too. And that just about sums it up. So thanks for coming along with me and happy holidays, everyone.
Hey friends, Nick and I wanted you to join us in decorating our tree. Nick's favorite part is always reminiscing about certain ornaments, like this cute T-Rex. Okay, are you ready for the best part?
Arrowhead, it's Gabby.
I hope that you all are having a wonderful holiday season and that you're able to celebrate the winter holidays somehow with your immediate family. So I have a bit of a dilemma for you guys. So last res 2019, I kind of dropped the ball on decorating the cabin. You know, our cabin theme was beach bums, and we made this big banner for outside of our cabin, and we had Lays and crabs, little crabs put all over the floor, and just different beach accessories, and I was just awful at setting it all up. I mean, you could ask Meredith or Elena or Bridget. I was not helpful. It was a total disaster. Eventually they were like, you know what, Gabby, why don't you go sit over there and we'll just set this up. So I really need to work on my decorating skills for next big res because I want it to be awesome and I want to be able to help out. So I thought today to practice, I could practice on a miniature house, a gingerbread house. Thankfully, this one that I got at the store came already built. So I don't need to assemble anything, which I feel like is the hardest part anyways. So I thought I would take you guys along and just show you how I'm gonna decorate this house. So at the end, you can let me know what you think, if I did a good job, if it's an improvement, if you think I'm headed down the right path. So let's get started. I think I'm gonna start by doing some lights on the roof. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that with these little candies that actually came in the package. They're like these little ball candies. So I'm gonna use the icing and try and drape them like lights on a house. So we will see how that goes.
Okay, so this is what I have so far on the house, the roof. So as you can see, I just put some little dots on both sides, and then I did a rainbow order of these like big gumballs on the top. So I think it's looking pretty good so far. I think I'm gonna start on the front of the house. I'm really not sure what to do, but I really want this to look great so I can impress you guys so that you trust me with the cabin decorations for our next res. So fingers crossed it goes well. Okay, this is what I have on the front. So I did some lights and I tried to light up the windows to make it look nice and cozy inside. And then I used these wafers to create a little walkway. I think it's looking pretty good. I'm a little bit nervous about these falling off. I've had some trouble keeping them on. And also, my hands, my phone, literally everything on this table is completely covered in frosting, which is not ideal. But you know what? We're gonna power through. I'm gonna work on the sides now. What do you guys think so far? Do you think I'm ready to decorate our cabin at Big Res? Okay, so I did the sides. I put some gumdrops in, and again, I just did that little pattern on the window. And guys, I'm honestly thinking that we should put in some rainbow shrubs around our cabins, because look how good that looks. And then in the front, I also added this tree. And I don't know, guys, maybe I have a really green thumb or just an eye for landscape and design, because although I wasn't that great at decorating the cabin, I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job with the lawn and the gardening of this house. Okay guys, so here's my finished product. I added some snow on top using powdered sugar to give it that dusted effect, it was just a little sprinkle of snow. I think it added a lot to the tree, actually.
All right, guys, so do you think I'm ready to decorate a cabin up at Big Res? I feel pretty ready, and I'm kind of loving the candy vibe of this house, so maybe that'll be a future cabin theme. Who knows? Hope you all are having an amazing time with your families this holiday season. Stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye!
And we are back. Well, for the first time ever, with an episode of Interviews, the show where I, your host, the interviewer, will have on different guests every episode and ask them some questions. Our first guest today is fresh off their recent trip to Mars. Please welcome Chet Rocketship. Great to be here, host. I can't wait to ask you some questions. Rockets up! No, wait. I'll be asking the questions. Wait, I thought I was asking you the questions, and you were answering them.
No, I think you have it backwards.
Do I?
Yes, you do.
But I just asked you a question, and you just answered it. You're right. Does this mean I'm answering the questions now? I'm afraid so. Tell me, host, what got you interested in interviewing?
Well, when I was younger, I always liked asking questions. Questions taught me to think about other people, and answers helped me learn about them. I would ask my parents how their day was going, I would ask my friends how they were doing, and I learned to love to ask questions and learning about people. Thank you for asking that question, Chet.
Cool. Very cool. Super interesting. So, what's your favorite color?
Glitter sparkles.
Favorite food?
Glitter sparkles.
Favorite two-word, four-syllable phrase?
Glitter sparkles.
Favorite art supply?
Glue sticks.
And that seems to be all the time we have, folks. Thanks to our guest today, me, for being so awesome, and thanks to our host, the interviewer, for teaching us all to love glitter sprinkles.
Today because I am going to be doing a belly flop into the snow for your entertainment. So I'm going to need some help. Susanna, can you give me a big 1, 2, 3?
1, 2, 3. Woo! Woo!
Success!
Hey guys, I know it's been a while since we've last seen each other, but I've been really doing a lot of work on my biology final right now. You know, it's the holiday season, but I got to finish this final first. The final project is I'm trying to hunt down this rare species of animal called a snowman. This only comes around during winter time because they hibernate every other time of the year. So we're on the look for one of those. They're pretty elusive.
Get down! See what's over there?
That's a bona fide snowman if I've ever seen one.
Find it right now. They're easily frightened. Alright, I'm very quiet. Turn the camera light off. Alright, we're getting close. Don't make a sound. I think we might finally get one. Wait, no, it's running away! No!
You know, I've been looking for one for like 2 months now. The whole class has just been finding a snowman, but it's really tough if there's no snow. They can dig underground, they can climb trees. Some say they can fly, haven't seen one of those yet. But they can be anywhere you look. Like there.
Wait!
Alright guys, we found some snowman tracks here. We gotta be very careful around these parts. Snowmen can be very dangerous. So the main concern here is that snowmen are very territorial. They don't like when their homes get invaded. So we gotta be very careful.
Run!
Alright, so I'm starting to run out of time, so I'm gonna try to set up a snowman trap. As everyone knows, snowmen can't get enough of graham crackers. So if we leave some right around here, in front of this box, I can then tie a string to it, and hopefully I can trap them.
All right, guys, we caught them.
Oh, guys, that took a lot out of me. Oh, but I finally caught a snowman. I'll be able to get my A+. It's a holiday miracle. I hope everyone else has a great holiday. Everyone else can catch their snowmen. And I hope to see you all soon.
Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy soul.
Hi guys, today I'm going to be making chocolate shortbread cookies. My family makes these every year, so I want to show you guys my recipe. I start with a stick and a half of butter and 3/4 cup of sugar. And then we're going to mix that together. Next, I'm going to add 1 egg and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And I'm going to mix that again. All right. Next, we're going to add 2 cups of flour, but we're going to do it little by little so it doesn't get everywhere. And then once that's mixed, the next step is to add 1/2 cup of cocoa powder, which is going to make it super chocolatey and delicious. So now it has to chill in the fridge for an hour before we bake it. So we'll show you what it looks like after that. All right, so the dough has been in the fridge for about an hour, and now it's nice and cold, so it's time to roll it out with a rolling pin and make it into some fun shapes. All right, so this is what they look like once they're all rolled out. We made them into cute little button shapes, and now we're gonna bake them in the oven. And here's the finished product. Too bad we don't have Smell-O-Vision because they smell delicious.